How's it doing, guys? It's Huck here. Growing my hair back in for reasons best kept to myself. How's it doing? Peace. I've been watching some videos on Southeast Asian street food on YouTube, right? The cliff notes of the story is I'm hopefully going on a holiday next year that will include 3 or 4 countries, right? In Southeast Asia, and the last one being China, right? So I've been watching all these videos about the do's, the don'ts, the street food, the fucking places to go, all that kind of stuff, you know what I mean? It started with me wanting to go to Thailand for a couple of weeks because my wife is going to China and I'm pretty bored of it at this stage. So I'm looking at the. I like checking out what the scams are. I always do that. The cost of things is usually a nice thing to know before you go so you don't get fucking robbed. And. But see, here's the thing, right? Not so much with Thailand, because I think Thailand's pretty fucking used to Westerners. But the videos, especially I've seen in Vietnam and Cambodia, they just look so fucking invasive. You're watching these nobodies, right? Right? These nobodies, right? Who are doing the top five foods in fucking Cambodia, right? And they've got their phone, they've obviously got their phone on a selfie stick. And first, they're talking about, oh, look at this lovely place, these lovely little plastic chairs, right? That you wouldn't fucking sit out your back garden in, right? But apparently, everything's lovely and everything's great, right? They're usually either Australian or Canadian, or Australian, Asian, Canadian, Asian type people, right? But they're like, oh, look at this, look how fucking, look at these paper plates, you know what I mean? Wow, right? And then they'll stick the camera right in these little fucking food carts. Well, the poor wee people probably couldn't have, I don't know, right? Cambodia, I believe, is one of the poorest countries in Southeast Asia. Vietnam, different, because you've got like Ho Chi Minh is really quite popular with tourists and stuff. But, funnily enough, it was a friend who was coming with me that suggested we go to Vietnam and Cambodia. And going to Cambodia seems a strange one for me because it's like having a holiday in Spain and taking a fucking day trip to Auschwitz. Do you know what I mean? Because the only thing I can think it's famous for is the killing fields, right? And I'm sure there's a tour. And it's like, in fact, I don't think I'd go to Auschwitz. I'd be like, do you want to go for a day to watch a place where loads of people died? And you're like, kind of, no, really, no. Not my choice of holiday destination. Where can I get me a sangria? Or, do you know what I mean? Like, where can I get me a fucking, a cold fruit drink? Some egg coffee, Vietnam. Right? So you're watching all these things where it's like, oh, number one, banh mi, which is like Vietnamese fucking baguette. And they're standing there fucking talking in front of people queuing up for their dinner, right? And it's. And then they'll stick the camera in the staff members' faces, they're ordering, and then they'll stick the camera in their own faces. And there was one video where there's an American dude who obviously must have lived in Vietnam, right? And two English guys. And you've got one guy's view of his phone recording. Where there's another guy recording as well, and then there's another one where there's a poor wee fucking, I want to say Vietnamese guy cooking, and there's three cameras pointing at this guy's fucking wok, right? And they're all talking to their fucking own cameras, and you're like, how stupid must they think the Vietnamese people think that fucking tourists are, right? Fucking, do you know what I mean? Like, oh, here comes another one with the phone, you know. Now, it's a fucking The strange thing is that I went looking for the videos, right? So I went looking for a video to see what the food was like. But I think you can do it less invasively. Do you know what I mean? I mean, they're not paying the staff that's cooking for the right to make these videos, right? So it's total fucking zero party consent. Do you know what I mean? Like, fucking, what's the story? Is it two party consent, one party consent? Right? But there's no, it's like expected that they can just shove the cameras in the face of somebody, right? If I was doing my job and somebody started fucking recording me, I would fucking hit them in the face with a selfie stick, right? They'd be shitting out. It was similar to, what was I watching? I was watching a reaction video to a song, right? And so maybe it's just fucking YouTubers in general, myself included, that maybe just suck balls, right? I was watching a YouTube video review, first view of a song called Suicide, right? By a guy called Ren. And it's not the reactions, it's the thumbnails, right? Where you'll see them, they'll right? And that's in the thumbnail, right? I seen one girl who, before the song started, started like that, before the song started, right? I seen another one, it was Suicide Survivor watches Ren's suicide video, right? And I thought to myself, if you survive, you're not a fucking suicide survivor. Nobody survives suicide, you fucking retard. And she's gone into it, and before the song starts, she's crying. And you're going, didn't watch it. I didn't watch it. As soon as she started crying, I flipped it over. Right? Because I just thought it was, what does a suicide survivor look like? Do you know what I mean? Unless they've got, unless it's like Ricky Ray Rector. Is it Ricky Ray Rector with half his fucking brain missing? Do you know what I mean? Like, clinically fucking retarded because he blew his fucking frontal lobe off, right? Attempted suicide survivor, I guess. Right, but back to the food stuffs, right? So it leads, it's something I really don't like when I go on holiday, is taking pictures, right? I will take selfies of me and my daughter to get some fucking memories, right? Because she's my wee darling, right? I mean, my wife or whatever, right? But I wouldn't stick my camera in the faces of people that never asked for it. Do you know what I mean? It's the cameras is always faced either at inanimate objects, possibly food. If it's for food, it's usually to fucking show somebody else, look at this, it's fucking grand, like, you know, try this. But it's never the locals, right? I would never stick my camera in the face of locals and just accept the fact and expect them to be happy with it. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's shocking. But it's the only thing, the irony is that it's me that's went looking for this video. Do you know what I mean? I'm looking for the information, and the information's there. It's just, in my opinion, they don't need to do all that shit. Do you know what I mean? They do, oh, look at this, you get chopsticks. Oh, and look, there's this person. Fucking, don't. There's a person, look, there she is. She only makes a euro a fucking week. Look at the state of that, like, you know, how great, right? And then they went with their fucking iPhone 14s and their fucking whatever stuff, do you know what I mean? And you think to yourself, surely they can provide the information without sticking a camera over this poor wee person's, like, they've literally got the hats on. Do you know the hat, the hat, if right, if I said Asian hat, what would you think of? One of them, right? They've literally got them on to stop the fucking sun beating down on them, right? And it's no ironic, do you know what I mean? It's not like a tourist fucking gimmick thing, right? And there's another one who's cooking, and they've got a wee trolley with all the food and stuff, and then there's a door. That's their house. They're selling outside their house, right? And these people are fucking, they've got the camera stuck in the fucking door. Right, and then in the background of the fucking shop, you know, get in front of shit, front of counter, fuck face. Do you know what I mean? That's not where you should be. This is my side, that's your side. Do you know what I mean? I'd be like a passenger getting in my driver's seat of my car. Do you know what I mean? I would say, bolt. Yeah. I've just after watching the video, top seven fucking Vietnamese foods, you know. Is it Cambodian? I was working Cambodian and Vietnamese, right? I can't remember what one it was, but there's these. Do you know the little plastic seats you would have your kids sit on? They look like they're molded, like just fucking one single mold seat. Well, that's basically what these people have put out for people to sit and eat. And they honestly, obviously, and they said, honestly said, "Oh, look at these lovely seats. That's what I like of this, the lovely seats." And you're going, you're taking a piss, right? If these people could understand English, they would fucking slap you, right? Right, rant over. I look tired. I look fucking tired, don't I? Jesus Christ, video is not kind to me. Yeah, if I was ever going to take pictures of fucking stuff, and in fact, like I said, I really don't. I don't take pictures. The only pictures I've got is usually got my daughter in them. And that's the reason they're there. It's not for the fucking. Yeah. Peace.